And now, people, time for something a little bit different on BoomBox Deluxe channel. Yes, once again, it is another BoomBox Friday, okay? We've got a little character up there in front of the camera, and he's quite happy there carrying his little boombox on his shoulder. Okay, there we go. Here's his boombox. Okay, I don't know what make and model that boombox is. But there we go. He's quite happy there. He's got his wearing his cap backwards. Okay. So there we are. That is, of course, one of the little Tetley tea folk. And yeah, I saw that up for grabs on a popular auction website and I had to have it. As like the boombox that he has sat on top of. Okay. I thought to myself, yeah, I would like one of those that will accompany my other one. And we're about to look at that now. I'm just going to move him off the top of there. Say cheerio to Mr. Tetley T Folk, ghetto blaster person. Okay, he's out of here. He's gone. Now then, this boombox is made by Sharp. Okay. This one is a little bit different from all of the other boomboxes that I've put up in front of the camera so far on BoomBox Friday. And next to the Sharp logo, it says they're both sides, and you're probably wondering both sides of what exactly. Well, if I move it along, it says boom, both sides play disc stereo system. Okay, both sides play disc stereo system. And the model number is VZ2500. Okay. Now then, this one that I've got up in front of the camera, there's two versions of this. Okay. Internally, they all work the same, but I've got the slightly more rarer version. And if I bring the camera along a bit more, okay, and tilt that down, what makes this one a slightly more rarer version is it says that on the front of it. Okay, BSLT. And that basically means both sides linear tracking. Okay. You can get, it looks very much the same with this type of boombox, but it doesn't have that wrote on the turntable door. Okay. When I pull the camera back in a minute, you'll see the boombox, which that is wrote on. Okay, this isn't as such what I would refer to as the sort of boombox you'd see out on the streets back in the 1980s, okay? I never saw one. And, but, what I will say, it is a portable unit, just like every other boombox that's been on BoomBox Friday, which is why this one is also on BoomBox Friday, because it's a portable unit, it's got a carry handle, everything's integrated, you can run it on batteries, and yes, it is a portable audio system. Okay, so therefore, it does, as per definition of the Worldwide Ghetto Massive, it does meet the criteria of a portable, you know, sound system, or boombox, ghetto blaster, or call it what you like. Okay, I'm going to pull the camera back now and you can have a full-on look at this boombox. But before I do, people, if I just turn the camera around a minute, we've got company. There's a Tobias. There he is. Do you want to come in, my Tobias? Do you want to come in? You do. He wants to come in, people. If you just hold on there a minute, I'll let in the Tobias. There he is. There's a Tobias.
Come along, then. Him.
goodness me, I've got the camera rolling out here, Tobias. Well, he was in a bit of a hurry to come in, wasn't he? Not. Right, let's pull this camera back, like I was saying, before I was interrupted by the Tobias. And let's have a look at that boombox, okay? 5.5 minutes. Let's feast your eyes on this. Here we go. There we go. Sharp VZ 2500 BSLT. Okay. Like I say, that is the slightly more rarer version because it says actually says BSLT on the turntable door. You can get these where it doesn't say BSLT on the turntable door. Okay, you can see it there. You can quite clearly see it says BSLT. Right there. Okay, there is a version of this available where that turntable door, it's got those lights on it like that, but it just doesn't say that on there. And I thought to myself, oh, it's a bit disappointing that. I want one where it's got BSLT right on the turntable door. So I've got one. Okay, I did look around for a long, long time to try and find one, and then one come up for grabs. And I thought to myself, I'm having it. And yeah, as an added bonus, the person that owned it before me said to me that they did put a new belt on the turntable. Okay, because that is a common failure point of one of these boomboxes. After a certain amount of years, as like any drive belt on any boombox, they do sort of wear out. Yes. Variants, okay, other variants of that boombox. There is a Japanese equivalent of that, and it is for Japan only. And I believe that is the VZ V2. Is it? No, V20. Okay, the VZ V20. And instead of having that silver bit up the top of the door there, that glass, it more or less goes right the way up to the top. Or top of the turntable door. And you can see that blue detailing's in the window there. You see all that blue detailing's in there? You've got that all the way up the top as well, like a little blue and black square grid on that. Let's zoom that camera out. There's the Tobias. Okay, carrying on. Okay, this is BoomBox Friday, not a feline video. Yes, so I said about variants of the Japanese version, VZ V20, and also, right, and it is proper sexy material. Again, it is for the Japanese market only, which is a bit of a shame. You can get that boombox in red. Yes, in red. You know, and they are very, very sort of super, super rare, those ones. I've only ever seen two. One came up for sale on a popular auction website many, many years ago, and I didn't have the money for it. And the other one, which I do believe has since been sold, featured on a website. And the shop, which is over in Japan, is otherwise known as Turbo Sonic. And they had the Japanese equivalent of that and the red one. Okay. That's how I know about the Japanese equivalent of that, because I saw it on Turbo Sonic website. Okay. For the more established member of the Worldwide Ghetto Massive, you'll know about Turbo Sonic. Okay. Like BoomBox Deluxe, for example. A more established member of the Worldwide Ghetto Massive. Let's get up closer on that boombox now, and let's have a look at some of the function controls and buttons and bits and pieces on it. And just over there, I've got the tape measure again, so we can measure up this mammoth of a boombox. Okay. Let's start over there with the tape deck. I know you're just itching to see that itching to see the turntable on that. And yes, that is a proper turntable, people. Tape deck. Okay. What we've got, all of the usual and more of the same. Okay. There it is. Got all the usual buttons and toys down the bottom there. Eject, record, play, stop, rewind, fast forward, and pause. Again, it's got the APSS on it. And when you're playing a track, if you want the next track to run, you've got your play going. When you want the next track to run, you just press fast forwards and it will find the next track. Okay. When it finds the next track, that fast forward button will pop out. The play button will still stay stuck in. And it will carry on playing as usual. Over there, we have got the power switch. Okay, there we go, power switch. And those lights there, we've got power wall battery. When it's turned on, that lights up. And then when you're recording on the tape deck, that one lights up. Dolby system on this one. Got Dolby noise reduction. On when it's pressed in and off when it's popped out. And on this one, we've got the tape selector once again. Okay. We'll just try and turn that tripod around so we can get a bit closer on it. Okay, right, what we got down there then, we've got tape. Normal, and then we've got chrome, and then we've got metal. Okay, so there we go. The tape deck on this one, I can't play a tape in it because the drive belt slips. And this is one of these drive tape decks where when you press play, it's the electric motor which moves the heads up into the tape. And the problem with that is, when you've got a slippy drive belt, when you press play, the heads come up and they only come up halfway and it gets stuck. Okay? And the problem with that is, if you've got a tape inside there, when that happens, you can't open this boombox up in order to rectify the situation. And as like some boomboxes, when that happens, the only way you can get the tape out or unstick it is basically, as much as it saddens me, you've got to basically smash the boombox up to get it out. You've got to rip that off or something like that. Or, you know, just after you've whipped all the screws out, try and jiggle the casing around so that you can somehow persuade the tape heads out of the tape. You can separate the two cases. Okay, there's that Tobias. I'm just trying to get him on camera. So yes, tape deck. Got a tape counter up there. I think we already know that because I was saying about the model number on it, wasn't I? Is that model number? Yeah, model number was I was saying about the VZ2500. That's the tape counter there. Now then, this turntable, which you're just itching to see. I know I'll keep on teasing you about that turntable, but we're going to go over to the other side of the boombox now. And we got all the other functions and controls on there, and the radio over this side. I'll just turn this around a minute. We've got a Tobias. What do you want, old Tobias? You're licking your chops, you want nibbles, don't you? If you let me do a Boombox Friday video, I should give you nibbles a little bit later. Okay. Tobias. Okay. You go out, right? And I will do you nibbles in a minute. Okay, I'm doing a Boombox Friday video, my little Tobias. Okay. Be patient, you're not wasting away. Okay. Right. He always wants feeding people. That's his little problem. And he's going to go pop if he carries on. Radio. Okay. Well, we've got all the usual functions and controls and bits and pieces on that. Once again, another 4-band radio on there. Okay. Another 4-band radio. We've also got all our functions and toys on that. We got tape, phono, and yes, look at that, on this one we've got an auxiliary control, FM stereo, FM, long wave, medium wave, which is the same as AM, and short wave. Okay, got the tuning control up the top there, and there's our little pointer thing there. Okay, you turn that and that goes backwards and forwards. Okay, and back the other way. I don't think this one's got a fine tuning control for the shortwave. I don't think it has. No, it doesn't. It doesn't have a fine tuning control for the shortwave, which is a little unusual. Okay, balance control. Oh dear. I didn't snap it off. Someone previous to me snapped it off, and when I went to use it, it fell off. Okay, I have recently opened this up, carefully of course, and inside there I can see that someone has tried gluing it back on, and when I've gone to use it, it's fallen off again. It could be worse, it could be the volume control, couldn't it? So I've got volume control there, it's a slider control, like so. There we go. And down there we've got a microphone volume. Okay, because this has got external jacks for microphones. And we've also got a bass control and a treble control. Okay, being a boombox that's got a built-in turntable, you can't have the bass set too high when you've got the turntable playing, because it will feed back to the stylus on the record and make it... it does like a distorted sound on the audio, and from what I've heard from some other members of the Worldwide Ghetto Massive, they refer to that kind of distortion as a grunting sound. Okay. Just around the side there, you know what I was saying about microphones? We got two. They are the larger size. I believe that's, hang on, I'll just have a look. I've got a feeling both of those are for microphone. One of them might be a headphone socket. Yes, one, the top one is microphone, and the lower one is your headphone socket. Okay, I thought that those were, I thought both of those were microphone. What do you want, my Tobias? Do you want to go out? Do you want to go out? I'll just let Toby back up a minute, people. Hold on. Do you want to go out? Come on, then. What do you want? You want nibbles. Okay, people, he's really pestering me for nibbles. If you just wait there a minute, I'm going to shove a few nibbles in his bowl, okay? Come on. You'll go pop if you keep on eating my tubby ass. Really, you will. Go on. Now leave me in peace, I've got to do a BoomBox Friday video. Nibbles. Right, so now that he's feeding people, hopefully, I shall be able to get the rest of this BoomBox Friday video done. My goodness me. I did say this was going to be something a little bit different on BoomBox Friday, but I wasn't expecting nibbles. Okay, oh dear, I folded the cat over. Never mind. Right, where was I before Toby wanted nibbles? I was saying about those jacks on the front there, weren't I? On the side there. So one's a microphone and the other one is your headphone socket. Okay, that turntable, you really want to see that turntable, let's do the turntable now. Okay, now, tape, let's just say a little thing about tape decks, okay, because this is going to be a little surprising for you. On some tape decks, on some pieces of hi-fi equipment, okay, hands up who's ever heard of auto-reverse. Okay, you know what auto reverse is? It's basically on a tape deck where it finishes playing one side and it automatically flips the tape over and starts playing side B. Okay, a lot of people think that is only for audio cassettes. Well, you're wrong, because remember that, well, it says both sides play. Now, that can only mean one thing. That turntable on there, it is auto-reverse. Yes. Okay, this is 1980s technology we're talking about here. And that turntable, when it's finished playing one side, it will automatically start playing the other side of the record. Okay, as it says there, computer controlled linear tracking. Okay, both sides play disc. Now this boombox, it is so big, I'm going to have to wind the tripod up the next step, okay? Just bear with me a minute while I get this tripod set up. I know it's going down, but that is because I've got to set the next stage up on the legs. Okay, and when I have done, the tripod will then be taller again. And then I can use the windy handle to bring the tripod right up a further level. Right, as you can see there, we've got our lights on there. Disc indicator, side A and side B. Okay, that one there, you can select a function where it, once it's finished playing side A, it will flip over and play side B. Then it will stop. Okay, the other function, that one, you can have it continuously looping. Okay, so you put a disc in, if you choose that function, it'll play side A, side B, side A, side B, side A, side B, all the time. Okay, that's what that is. And you've got your controls up the top there. Door open. I will press that in a minute and we can have watch the door open. Side A. Oh, what, Tobias? What? What do you want now? You've had nibbles, haven't you? You continuously interrupt me. My goodness me, he wants to go out now, people. Study those buttons up there and I shall be back in a moment or two. Come on, you're pestering me, aren't you? Go on. Go find that kitten. Okay, people, he's gone out. The Tobias has gone out. So, those buttons up the top there, look, I was saying. We got speed. 33 and 45. Okay, it does not do 16 and it does not do 78. So two speed, 33 and 45. Can I get a zoom on that? It's a bit, isn't it? But you get the idea, 33 and 45. Okay, we'll have a look at that on the top there in a minute. Okay, side A and side B. And that's those controls that I was saying to you about. Repeat. Okay, got both sides there. You press that. And that light there would come on. And when you press that, that light would come on. Okay. To deselect again, you just press it again and that light would go out. Those ones there, a bit like what you've got on a tape deck. You can actually fast forward and rewind. Okay. While it's playing, the tape, the turntable, while it's playing, if you was to press forward, it would lift the stylus off the record. The stylus would move along. See that? There's the stylus there. It would lift off the record. It would move along. And then when you let go of that button, it would then drop the needle back on the record. Okay. Again, forward is that direction. And reverse, which is that one, would be back in the other direction. Okay, bearing in mind that a record plays from the outside, from the outer edge into the middle. Okay, then you've got your cue button. Okay, you can manually take the needle on and off the record. Okay, you press that and it'll drop the stylus onto the record. And when you press that, it will lift it back off again. And you've also got your play and your cut button. Okay, with this turntable, when you put a record in, as you close the door, if you've got it set on to the phono, okay, so you press that like that, you open the turntable door, And when you put the record in and close it, it will automatically start playing. Okay. It is that automatic. So you press your phone 01, you open the door, put your record in, and as soon as you close it, it will start playing the record for you. You don't need to press any buttons. It does it automatically. Okay. And if you don't want it to, you then just press that and it will stop. Okay. So there we go. On this one, it's got a nice smooth function on opening the tape, the turntable door. I will press that now. Okay. Here we go. Enjoy. Okay. So it opens up nicely. Let's have a look inside that turntable. Right, what we've got inside there, there's two lights. Okay. One inside there, and the other light is inside there. What they do is when you put a single in, you know, like a seven inch single, the 7-inch single will cover that light up, okay? When you close the turntable door, there will be a detector mechanism, okay? And what that detector mechanism does, if you remember me saying when you close the door, the turntable starts playing the record automatically, it is so that the little microcomputer controller in there can determine where to move the needle to in order to find the beginning of the record. Just over there, that is the stylus for side B. Okay, just there, that device. That is the stylus for side B. Side A stylus is inside the door. Okay. And of course, when you put a 12-inch single in, or an album or whatever, LP or whatever you wish to call it, it covers up both of those lights, and therefore it knows that it's a full size 12-inch, and therefore it moves the needle to the beginning of the record accordingly. Okay, that's what those are for. That there is obviously the turntable mechanism. And that section there, which springs in and out, if you remember years ago, you could get those jukebox records with the large hole in the middle. This turntable will accept those because of that section there. That section would pop through into the middle of a jukebox record. Okay? If you've got the record which has only got the small hole, that obviously can press in like that. And then it rotates, okay. But yeah, it does accept the jukebox records, okay, the little 7-inch singles. So there we go. It's all clever stuff, and it is 1980s technology, very very cutting edge for its time, I would seem to think. And of course, because of that, very very expensive. Okay, it is a Sharp. Okay. So yeah, I wouldn't mind betting when this was brand new in the shops, it was very expensive. When you close the door, there's that there. And that obviously, the record gets compressed between that there and that. As you can see, it's on a spring. Okay. There's a little dial down here that... Okay, that corresponds with those lights there. Okay. You can choose, if you want, it's got three modes on it. It's got auto, and you've got LP, if I to turn that, I believe. Oh, no, I do believe it turns. There we go. That's now on LP mode. Okay, when you put it on LP, if you used to put a 7-inch single in, I do believe, yeah, you put a 7-inch single in there, it might damage the mechanism because when you turn that, it covers up the little sensors so that you could manually override those lights. Remember I was saying about those lights? Okay. Yeah, so it's all good stuff in there. I've got a feeling my memory card's about to run out, people. And if you put it on, it's a bit difficult to turn it. If you put it on EP, it covers up the lower little sensor. Let's try turning it back to auto. It's quite difficult to turn it. There we go, I've put it back to auto. So it will automatically detect your record size. Okay, and then when you close the turntable door, you just push it closed, like so. And if there was a record in there, that would now start. Now then, Sharp also done portable hi-fi versions of that. And on the portable hi-fi version, when you put the record in, you press the door open button, which is open and close. And when you press it, it will automatically close the door for you. Okay. Because of memory card limitations, I'm going to have to cut this short. But before I do, I will show you all that business on the top there. Okay. There we go. You've got like a little circuit diagram of what works, how it all works inside. Okay. It's got some symbols and bits and pieces on there. There you go. Symbol for record head and erase head. Okay, it was all technical back in the 80s. You had all this sort of business. Okay. 4-bit high-speed microcomputer. Okay. It's all on there. So yeah, not only is it a boombox, but it's an electronics lesson at the same time. It's all on there. And there we go. So I'm going to have to cut this short, people, because I've got a feeling my memory card is about to run out. But yeah, it runs on batteries. Okay, 10 D cells would go in there. And you cannot... Right, I will say this, you cannot play a record while carrying it. Okay, because it's got a sensor. It's got 4 feet on the bottom of it. And inside one of the feet, there's a button which pops out. And, yeah, when you pick it up, if the record's playing, the button pops out and turns the record player off. Okay. Yeah. 10 D cells on that. It's got the auxiliary input on it. I will just turn it around. If this runs out, you know what happened, okay? Bear with me a minute. Okay, there's the back of it. Okay, there's your mains input just there. Battery compartment, 10 D cells in there. These are auxiliary inputs. There, auxiliary input. External antenna and external speakers. And what's that? SW selectors. SW medium wave selectors. You can have it on internal antenna or external antenna. Okay, and there's your beat cancel there. That you've got A and B on that again. Okay. Again, you've got 15 volts DC input jack on that. So there we go. I've got a feeling this memory card really about to go now. 34 minutes. Like I say, there's a monster of a boombox. I would have done the tape measure. Okay, let's see if I can quickly get the tape measure in. If not, if this cuts off, you know I didn't get the tape measure in. It's about 30 inches wide, I believe. Okay. If this cuts off, you know what happened. The memory card ran out. Yeah, 28 inch. Okay. It's quite a sizable boombox. 28 inch or 720 wide. With the handle up, it's about 20 inch tall. No, it's about 18 actually. 18 inches tall, or that would be 460 millimeters tall. And it's got quite a depth on it as well. and that is 7 inches deep or 180 millimeters. Right, before I lose this on the memory card, I'm going to wrap this up for 35 minutes and 30 seconds, okay? So that was the Sharp VZ2500 BSLT, people, okay? There will be more boomboxes coming up a little bit later on BoomBox Friday on BoomBox Deluxe's channel. So, for now, hope you enjoyed that one. I know I had to rush it a bit towards the end, but there we go. Yeah, thanks for watching, okay? Do stay tuned, there will be more boomboxes on the way. 36 minutes, thanks for watching.